This was brought to you by Roger Hansen, Gaming with Infamous, on YouTube, Roger Hansen on Patreon, and Franklin County Internet Society on Facebook.
Chapter 1, Weapons and Armor. The two most important pieces of equipment many D&D characters will ever own are their primary weapons and their armor that protects them. The new weapons and armor described here, which supplement the gear available in Chapter 7 of the Player's Handbook, are designed for medium-sized creatures. Some creatures, such as giants and pixies, wield weapons with different sizes than those presented in the Player's Handbook. These usually sized weapons have different characteristics, including damage, weight, cost, range, increment, and reach. Size and damage. If you design a version of a particular weapon that is larger or smaller than the standard presented in the Player's Handbook, you'll need to recalculate how much damage it deals. To determine the damage a larger or smaller weapon deals, first determine how many size categories it varies from the standard. A longsword, normally medium size and commonly used by medium sized beings, suited for a huge cloud giant is two size categories bigger. Consult Table 1, Damage for Larger Weapon, for Table 1 and 2, Damage for Smaller Weapons. Finding the weapon's original damage in the left column and reading across to the right to find its new damage. For example, the Cloud Giant's longsword is increased twice as its base damage of 1d8, so it deals 3d6 points of damage. Light and heavy crossbows. These weapons use the rules above. They follow the same cost and weight changes as other weapons, but are called out of Table 1, 3, Damage for Larger and Smaller Crossbows. Size, weight, and price. If you're designing a weapon larger than the standard and its weight increases by 50% for each size category increase. Its cost increases at the same rate. So if you design a large version of a throwing axe, ordinary a small weapon weighing 4 pounds, it will weigh 9 pounds. The medium size version weighs 6 pounds, and a large version increases the weight by a further 50%. Its cost increases by the same amount, so a light throwing axe would cost 18 GP. Weights decrease by 25% per size category. Decrease if you're designing a smaller version of a weapon. A throwing axe weighs only 3 pounds if you make a tiny version of it. Costs also decrease by 25% per size category. Decrease. So a tiny throwing axe would cost only 6 GP. Table 1-1, Damage for Larger Weapons. original damage 1, first increase 1 die 2, second increase 1 die 3, third increase 1 die 4, fourth increase 1 die 6, fifth increase 1 die 8, sixth increase 2 die 6. Original damage 1 die 2, first increase 1 die 3, second increase 1 die 4, third increase 1 die 6, fourth increase 1 die 8, fifth increase 2 die 6, sixth increase 3 die 6. Original damage 1 die 3. First increase 1 die 4. Second increase 1 die 6. Third increase 1 die 8. Fourth increase 2 die 6. Fifth increase 3 die 6. Sixth increase 4 die 6. Original damage 1 die 4. First increase 1 die 6. Second increase 1 die 8. Third increase 2 die 6. Fourth increase 3 die 6. Fifth increase 4 die 6. Sixth increase 6 die 6. Original damage 1 die 6. First increase 1 die 8. Second increase 2 die 6. Third increase 3 die 6. Fourth increase 4 die 6. Fifth increase 6 die 6. Sixth increase 8 die 6. Original damage 2 die 4. Now 1 die 6. First increase 1 die 8. Second increase 2 die 6. Third increase 3 die 6. Fourth increase 4 die 6. Fifth increase 6 die 6. Sixth increase 8 die 6. Original damage 2 die 4. First increase 2 die 6. Second increase 3 die 6. Third increase 4 die 6. Fourth increase 6 die 6. Fifth increase 8 die 6. Sixth increase 12 by 6. Original damage 1 die 8. 2 die 4. First increase 2 die 6. Second increase 3 die 6. Third increase 4 by 6. Fourth increase 6 die 6. Fifth increase 8 die 6. Sixth increase 12 die 6. Original damage 1 die 8. First increase 2 die 6. Second increase 3 die 6. Third increase 4 die 6. Fourth increase 6 die 6. Fifth increase 8 die 6. Sixth increase 12 die 6. 6. Original damage. 1 die 10. First increase 2 die 8. Second increase 3 die 8. Third increase 4 die 8. Fourth increase 6 die 8. Fifth increase 8 die 8. Sixth increase 12 die 8. Original damage. 1 die 12. First increase 3 die 6. Second increase 4 die 6. Third increase 6 die 6. Fourth increase 8 die 6. Fifth increase 10 die 6. Sixth increase 6 die 6. Original damage. 1 die 20. First increase 4 die 6. Second increase 6 die 6. Third increase 8 die 6. Fourth increase 12 die 6. Fifth increase 6 die 6. Sixth increase 12 die 6. Table 1-2. Damage for smaller weapons. Original damage 1 die 2. First increase 1. Second decrease slash. Third decrease slash. Fourth decrease slash. Fifth decrease slash. Sixth decrease slash. Original damage 1 die 3. First decrease 1 die 2. Second decrease 1. Third decrease slash. Fourth decrease slash. Fifth decrease slash. Sixth decrease slash. Original damage 1 die 4. First decrease 1 die 3. Second decrease 1 die 2. Third decrease 1. Fourth decrease slash. Fifth decrease slash. Sixth decrease slash. Original damage. 1 die 4. First decrease. 1 die 3. Second decrease. 1 die 2. Third decrease 1. Fourth decrease slash. Fifth decrease slash. Sixth decrease slash. Original damage. 1 die 6. First decrease 1 die 4. Second decrease 1 die 3. Third decrease 1 die 2. Fourth decrease 1. Fifth decrease slash. Sixth decrease slash. Original damage 1 die 6. First decrease 1 die 4. Second decrease 1 die 3. Third decrease 1 die 2. Fourth decrease 1. Fifth and sixth is slash. Original damage 2 die 4. First decrease 1 die 6. Second decrease 1 die 4. Third decrease 1 die 3. Fourth decrease 1 die 2. Fifth decrease 1. Sixth slash. Original damage 1 die 8. First decrease 1 die 6. Second decrease 1 die 4. third decrease, 1 to 3, fourth decrease, 1 to 2, fifth decrease, 1, sixth decrease, slash. Original damage, 1 to 10, first decrease, 1 to 8, second decrease, 1 to 6, third decrease, 1 to 4, fourth decrease, 1 to 3, fifth decrease, 1 to 2, sixth decrease, 1. Original damage, 1 to 12. First decrease, 1 to 10. Second decrease, 1 to 8. Third decrease, 1 to 6. Fourth decrease, 1 to 4. Fourth decrease, 1 to 4. Fifth decrease, 1 to 3. Sixth decrease, 1 to 2. Table 1-3. Damage for larger and smaller crossbows. Crossbow type, light. Fine, 1 to 2. Diminutive, 1 to 3. Tiny, 1 to 4. Small, 1 to 6. Medium size, 1 to 8. Large, 2 to 6. Huge, 3 to 6. Gargantuan, 4 to 6. Colossal, 6 to 6. Crossbow type, heavy. Fine, 1 to 3. Diminutive, 1 to 4. Tiny, 1 to 6. Small, 1 to 8. Medium size, 1 to 10. Large, 2 to 8. Huge, 3 to 8. Gargantuan, 4 to 8. Colossal, 6 to 8. Size and range. Larger and smaller versions of ranged weapons have correspondingly longer or shorter range increments. Each time you increase a weapon's size, lengthen its range increment by 25%. For example, huge longbows, such as those wielded by ogre mages, have a range increase of 125 feet. Each time you decrease a weapon size, shorten its range increment by 25%. A medium-sized longbow in the hands of a halfling has a range increment of 75 feet. Size and reach. Most weapons keep the same effective range no matter what their size, although the reach of their potential wielders certainly have changes. However, weapons that normally have a reach of greater than 5 feet have different reaches when you design them at different sizes. If you're designing a larger version of such a weapon, increase its reach by 5 feet for each size category it increases. A huge goose arm has a reach of 15 feet. For example, while a gargantuan goose arm has a reach of 20 feet, designing smaller versions of reach weapons quickly makes reach irrelevant. A reach of 5 feet is normal for medium-sized and small creatures. The important difference is that tiny creatures using small reach weapons can fight in melee as if they had 5 feet of reach, meaning they do not have to enter an opponent's space to attack. New weapons. The following weapons, mostly exotic weapons and new ammunition for range weapons, are suitable for a broad variety of D&D campaigns. Many are of Asian origin in the real world, but in your game, they can come from anywhere. Monk weapon list. Add the following weapons to the monk's weapon list. Butterfly sword, Psy tiger claw, Tunfa, 3-section staff, and warband. All except the 3-section staff can be used with the monk's unarmed base attack bonus, including her more favorable number of attacks per round. See Table 310 in Chapter 3 of the Player's Handbook. Her damage, however, is standard for the weapon, not her unarmed damage. The weapon must be light, so a small monk must use tiny versions of these weapons in order to use the more favorable base attack bonus. See larger and smaller weapons above. A monk can also use her more favorable unarmed base attack bonus and number of attacks per round with the 3-section staff, provided she takes the exotic weapon proficiency feat for the weapon due to its large size. Small monks must use a medium-sized version of these section staff. No, of the 3-section staff. Ammunition and weapons proficiency. Ammunition for ranged weapons requires no particular proficiency to use, although the weapons that propel the ammunition, usually bows, do the exotic weapons proficiency. Fear isn't required. To use any item in the ammunitions category on Table 1-4. Weapons and descriptions text below. Weapons descriptions. The weapons found on Table 1-4 weapons are described below. Arrow Alchemist. Each of these projectiles carries a deadly load of alchemist fire in its hollow shaft. When it strikes a target, the arrow shatters, releasing the alchemist fire directly onto the target. One round after the impact, the alchemist fire ignites, dealing 1d4 points of damage. The target can use a full round section to attempt to extinguish the flames before taking this damage. It takes a successful reflex saving throw, DC 15, to extinguish the flames. Rolling on the ground earns the target a +2 bonus on the save. Submerging, such as by leaping into a lake or magically extinguishing flames automatically, kills the flames. Arrow, light. The light shaft and special design of the masterwork arrow increases the bow's range increment by 25 feet. Arrow signal. The arrow is specially designed to emulate a bird's call when fired. Even Fletcher's craft the arrows to make calls that will be recognized as signals by the elves of the community, for example. A hawk's cry might signal an attack, and an owl's screech might signal a stealthy advance. A successful wilderness lure check, DC-20, determines whether the sound comes from a bird or another source. The intricate carving of the arrow shafts make them clumsy in flight, imposing a -2 circumstance penalty on attack rolls. Arrow thunder. Thunder arrows are tipped with thunderstones. See Chapter 7 of the Player's Handbook. A hit from a thunder arrow deals no damage but triggers the thunderstone's sonic attack. Thunder arrows that miss should be treated as attacks with a grenade-like weapon. See Chapter 8 of the Player's Handbook. Battle Pick Gnome. A gnome battle pick is crafted and weighted to be used by creatures of small size. The small character can use a gnome battle pick two-handed as a martial weapon. Weighted Gauntlet. Unlike with the standard gauntlet, an attack with the bladed gauntlet is not considered an unarmed attack. The bladed gauntlet has two blades that extend from the back of the wrist following the line of the firearm. The cost and weight are for a single gauntlet. Bolus, two ball. A set of two-ball bolas consists of two heavy wooden spears connected by links of cord. It is a ranged weapon used to trip an opponent when they throw a set of bolas. You make a ranged touch attack against your opponent. If you hit your opponent, must succeed on a dexterity or strength check opposed by your strength check or be tricked. Bolas can only trip medium size or smaller targets. Your opponents cannot trip you when you make a trick attack with a set of two-ball bolas. Bolt tumbling. A tumbling bolt resembles a standard crossbow bolt, except for a few minuscule holes and vents along the shaft. The channel allows air to pass through the bolt, which causes the bolt to rumble when fired. The bolt deals +2 damage, but only has 1/2 its normal range increments due to the way the projectile moves through the air. Calculus Gnome. This oversized sling is made to fire flasks filled with liquid. Common ammunition includes acid, alchemist fire, and other alchemical substances. Alchemical ammunition deals damage according to its properties, but it gains the range increment of the known calculus. Chain and dagger. When wielding the chain and dagger, you gain a +2 bonus on your opposed attack roll when attempting to disarm an opponent, including the roll to keep from being disarmed yourself if you fail to disarm your foe. You can also use this weapon to make trip attacks, gaining a +2 bonus on your trip attempt. If you are tripped during your own trip attempt, you can opt to drop the chain and dagger instead of being tripped. Chakram. The chakram is a growing disc or wood about 1 foot in diameter with a sharpened outer ring. Claw bracer. A claw bracer is a metal armband which, with 3 steel claws projecting from the top, extending about 4 inches beyond the tip of the wearer's extended fingers. The wearer can cast spells normally while wearing the bracer and cannot be disarmed. Many claw bracers are enhanced as magic weapons. Label 1-4 weapons. Martial weapons melee. Item: large. Lucerne hammer. Cost: 12 GP. Damage: 2d4. Crit: x4. Range increment / weight: 10 pounds. Fight 2. Piercing. Item: large. Maul: 15 GP. Damage: 1d10. Crit: x3. Range increment - weight: 20 pounds. Type 2. Bludgeoning. Exotic weapons melee. Item: tiny. Claw bracer 1. Cost 30 GP. Damage 1d4. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range increment - weight 2 pounds. Type 2. Piercing. Item: tiny. Panther claw 1. 75 GP gold pieces. Damage 1d4. Crit times 3. Range increment / weight 3 pounds. Type 2. Piercing. Slashing. Item: tiny. Stump knife 1. 8 gold pieces. Damage 1d4. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range increment - weight 2 pounds. Piercing. Item: tiny. Tiger claws 1. Cost 5 gold pieces. Damage 1d4, crit times 2, range increment - weight 2 pounds. Tycoon Heresy. Item Tiny Triple Dagger 1. Cost 10 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 4. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range increment dash weight 1 pound. Type 2 piercing. Item type tiny. Wizard Cephas 1. Cost 10 gold pieces. Damage special 1. Critical special 1. Range increment dash. Weight 4 pounds. Type 2 bludgeoning. Item small. Battle pit no. Cost 10 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 6. Crit times 4. Range increment dash. Weight 5 pounds. Type 2 piercing. Item small. Gauntlet bladed. 30 gold, cost 30 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 6. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range increment dash. Weight 4 pounds. Type 2 slashing. Item small. Psi 1. Cost 1 gold piece. Damage 1 die 4. Crit times 2. Range increment dash. Weight 2 pounds. Type 2. Piercing. Item small. Sapphire 1. Cost 15 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 6. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range increment dash. Weight 2 pounds. Type 2. Actually, Sapphire is 15 gold pieces for the cost. Damage 1 die 6. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range increment dash. Weight 6 pounds. Type 2 slashing. Item small sword butterfly. Cost 10 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 6. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range increment dash. Weight 2 pounds. Type 2 slashing. Item small. Pompa. But cost 2 silver pieces. Damage 1 die 6. Crit times 2. Range increment dash. Weight 2 pounds. Type 2 bludgeoning. Item small. Warband 1. Cost 30 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 6. Crit times 3. Range increment dash. Weight 1 pound. Type 2 slashing. Item medium size. Chain and dagger. Cost 4 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 4. Crit 19 through 20 times 2. Range increment dash. Weight 4 pounds. Type 2 piercing. item, medium size, Popesh, cost 20 gold pieces, damage 1 die 8, critical 19 through 20 times 2, range increment dash, weight 12 pounds, type 2 slash. Item, medium size, long sword, mercurial, cost 400 gold pieces, damage 1 die 8, crit times 4, range increment slash, weight 6 pounds, type 2 slash. Item, large. Glum, 3. Cost 20 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 8. Crit times 3. Range increment slash. Weight 8 pounds. Type 2 piercing. Item, large. Greatsword, mercurial. Cost 600 gold pieces. Damage 2 die 6, crit times 4, range increment slash, weight 17 pounds, type 2 slashing. Item, large. Gearspike, 14. Cost 90 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 8 through 1 die 8. Crit 19 to 20 times 2. Range increment slash. Weight 20 pounds. Type 2 bludgeoning. Item large. Mace double 4. Cost 125 gold pieces. Damage 1 die 8 slash 1 die 8. Crit times 2. Range increment dash. Weight 25 pounds. And type 2 bludgeoning. The curse bite is type 2 bludgeoning and slashing. And then the mace double 4 is just type 2 bludgeoning. Item, large, Mantle 1, cost 15 gold pieces, damage 1 die 8, crit times 3, range increment slash, weight 9 pounds, type 2 piercing. Item, large, scimitar, double 4, cost 125 gold pieces, damage 1 die 6, dash 1 die 6, crit 18 through 20 times 2, range increment dash, weight 15 pounds, type 2 slashing. Item, large, 3 section staff, cost 4 gold pieces, damage 1 die 8, crit times 3, range increments slash weight 8 pounds, type 2 bludgeoning. Item, huge. Full blade 1, cost 100 gold pieces, damage 2 die 8, crit 19 through 20 times 2, range increment dash, weight 23 pounds. Type 2 slash.
This was brought to you by Roger Hanson, Gaming with Infamous, on YouTube, Patreon, and Anchor. We are on Franklin County Internet Gaming Society on Facebook too. We thank you for your participation. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, share, make comments. We love feedback.